Well, today on Commodities Market Update, the focus is rice. According to a report from the Economist Intelligence Unit, global rice production is expected to be 509 million tons, which is a 1% increase from last year at 504 million tons. Nigeria, being a major consumer, imports 2.0 million tons, which is about 11% of African imports. Recently, interventions by the CBN through the Anchor Borrowers Program have disbursed about 615.4 billion naira towards the goal of self-sufficiency in rice production. Have these interventions failed? Let's talk to Abimbola Adiguna, research analyst at Financial Derivatives Company. Great to have you. Well, despite the interventions like the Anchor Borrowers Program, the price of rice is still at 30,000 naira per 50-kilogram bag. Does this mean that the program is not effective?
Thank you for having me. Well, the AB program is actually effective because so far there has been an increase in the production of local rice. So the increase in price of rice actually started from when there was a ban on importation of rice. And this shifted the consumers, and this shifted the demand for rice, local rice. And the demand for rice is actually more than how much they're producing in the country. So the fact that there was scarcity in the production of rice, the price of rice increased. While and since then, since the hike of the price of rice and local rice, it hasn't dropped since then. And this is due to the activities that are actually going on now, like the herdsmen in the northern part of Nigeria, that's affecting the farmers' productivity.
All right, I guess it's still the insecurity issue affecting. But Christmas is fast approaching, and the price of rice is expected to, you know, spike during the period due to high demand. The price of a 50 kg bag presently at 30,000, which is a 3% increase compared to last Christmas. That was about 29,000. It's not really a significant price hike, you know, when compared to other food items in the inflation basket. Does that imply a production increase or, you know, substitution due to low consumer income?
Okay, so like I mentioned earlier, due to the ABE program, local production of rice has increased. But then because of the inflation that is going on now, it has affected the consumers' income. So their purchasing power has reduced. They won't, unlike last year, they won't want to buy as much, or they won't buy as much quantity of rice as they used to. So due to this, they have shifted their demand to other products in the inflation baskets, other items in inflation baskets. And this has, because of the increase in demand of those items, there has been increase in price. So yeah.
All right. So locally produced rice, like fada, is believed to have, you know, more nutritional benefits than polished white rice. So, you know, considering the increasing global affinity towards health and healthier alternatives, could this be why fada is more expensive than regular white rice?
So the awareness of the health benefits of nutritional benefits of fada has made the demand of fada to increase, and because of that, the price actually increased. But then, fada is not, compared to white rice, which is grown in almost all the states in Nigeria, fada rice is only grown in the south, it's majorly grown in the southwest of Nigeria. So the supply of fada rice compared to the demand is low. So that has increased the price of fada rice compared to white rice.
All right, Abimbola, I guess maybe I'm going to get fada sauce today to, you're making me hungry for rice. All right, Abimbola, thank you so much. Analyst at Financial Derivatives Company, thank you for coming on the program.